So we have done the problems without invoice price. Now we are doing the problems with invoice price. So whenever we send the goods, what we'll write? Two goods sent on consignment is for sending the goods. On the debit side of consignment, all the expenses will come. Two cash is for what? Expenses made by consignor. Two consignee is for expenses made by consignee. Two consignee is for commission. By consignee is for sales. By consignment stock is for unsold stock. So two goods sent on consignment is for sending the goods. Two cash is for expenses made by consignor. Two consignee is for expenses made by consignee. Two consignee is for commission. By consignee is for sales. By consignment stock is for unsold stock. This was a standard proforma, and also I taught you with the entries. But whenever we send the goods at invoice price, what I said, this has to be unloaded by writing on the credit side. So because you are adding extra price here, that has to be unloaded by goods sent on consignment. This is for unloading of the goods sent. Unloading of goods sent. And unsold stock, whenever you're selling the goods at invoice price, the agent will value the goods at invoice price. This has to be unloaded by writing on the debit side to consignment stock reserve. So for unloading of the consignment stock, what we should write? To consignment stock reserve. I am writing here consignment stock reserve. So two additional entries has come. One is for unloading of the goods sent, and the other one is what? Unloading of what? Unsold stock. Let me teach you the 11th problem now. Radha of Secunderabad. Radha consigned 100 boxes of toy goods to Hari of Haryana. The cost of each box is 400 and invoice price is what? 500 per box. So in this problem, I told you in invoice price we have got four cases. We have to identify which case it is. First one is what? Add-on cost. Add-on cost. He will give you the cost price and he will ask you to add something on cost. Sometimes he will give you direct invoice price will be given. Sometimes he will say profit on sales. And sometimes he will give you cost price and invoice price, both are given. In this problem, what is said? Radha of Secunderabad consigned 100 boxes of toy goods to Hari of Haryana. The cost of each box is 400 and invoice price is 500. So he is sending the goods, 100 boxes at 400 each. So 40,000 is the goods sent. But what is the invoice price he has given you? 100 into 500. 50,000 is the invoice price. So what is given in the problem? He has given you cost price and invoice price. Which case it is? The fourth case. Cost price and invoice price both are given. Cost price is what? 40,000. And invoice price is what? 50,000. What is the extra price we are adding? 10,000 is the extra price, which is called as what? Loading. So now in order not to reveal exact profit to the consignee, the consignor is adding extra price and sending the goods. So he is sending the goods at what? 50,000. Whenever he sends the goods, what we'll write? Two goods sent on consignment. So what is the journal entry we'll pass for this? Consignment account data. Two goods sent on consignment. Consignment account data to goods sent on consignment. This is the entry we have to pass. Consignment account data to goods sent on consignment 50,000. Whenever we send the goods, the entry is consignment account data to goods sent on consignment 50,000. So two goods sent on consignment. In goods sent on consignment, what will come? By consignment, 50,000. Two cash is for expenses made by consignor. So whatever extra price, here only I'll unload the goods. What is the extra price I'm adding? The cost price was 40,000, but the invoice price is what? 50,000. What is the extra price I added? 10,000 is the extra price. This is called loading. Whatever loading I have done to this when I am sending the goods, that has to be unloaded for finding out the correct profit. So what is the entry? Goods sent on consignment account data to consignment. This is for unloading of the goods. 10,000. In goods sent on consignment, we will write as what? To consignment. 10,000. And in goods item, by goods item, 10,000 is the goods item. Why we are unloading the goods? To find out the correct profit. So see now, 50,000 minus 10,000, you get the, got the cost price or not? Yeah, you got the cost price. 40,000 is the cost price. Here we have added extra that has been unloaded. The entry is what? Consignment to goods center on consignment. In goods center on consignment, we wrote by consignment 50,000. Whenever you are unloading, what we wrote? By goods center on consignment. The entry is goods center on consignment to consignment. In goods center on consignment to consignment. To consignment is what? 10,000. Baki sab same. Radha paid 2,000 for forwarding charges. So whenever you send for forwarding charges, 2,000 is what? Expenses met by consignment. The entry is what? Consignment account data to cash. You know the entries, right? I am not writing the entries now. I will be writing only for unloading of the goods. So two goods sent on consignment is what? 50,000. Unloading of the goods. By goods sent on consignment is what? 10,000 for unloading the goods. Expenses met by consignment, 2,000. And next, Hari advanced 30,000 to Radha and sent account sales with the details. So Hari has given 30,000 as advance. In the consigning, who is consigning here? Hari is consigning. Hari is giving an advance of what? 20,000 or 40,000? 20,000 as what? Advance. 30,000 as advance. So write 30,000 by bank. In consignee, what will write? To consignment is for sales. By bank is for advance. By consignment is for expenses made by consigning. By consignment is for commission. By bank is for settlement. You know the performance. Consignee's account will not change. So what is the entry? Bank to consignee is for what? Advance. Next, Radha and he sent an account sales stating that 80 boxes were sold at what? 500 each. He sold 80 boxes at 500. 80 into 500 is how much? 40,000. By consigning, it is what? 40,000 is for what? Sales. Next, his expenses were 1500 towards what? Expenses. So expenses met by consigning, two consignees for expenses and two consignees for commission. Both has been given. Expenses is what? 1500 and commission is directly given. 2000 as what? Commission. Now calculation of unsold stock. You have to find out whether there is unsold stock in the problem or not. Unsold stock is there. How can you say unsold stock is there in the problem or not? How many goods we have sent to the consignee? 100 cases has been sent. In that 80 are sold, 20 are remaining. I taught you how to calculate the unsold stock. The valuation of unsold stock. We have sent 100, sold 80, unsold stock remaining is what? 20. Now we need to calculate the value unsold stock for 20 units. So write the valuation of unsold stock. Value of unsold goods. Now you all know we have sent the goods at invoice price. That is what? At 50,000. For 100 cases, we have sent at 50,000. What is the stock remaining? 20. For 20, how much? Cross multiply, you'll get 10,000. Add proportionate expenses of consigner. What is the proportionate expense of consigner? Consigner is spending 2,000. For 100 cases, he is spending 2,000. For 20 cases, how much? It is 400. If you cross multiply, you get what? 400. Expenses met by consigner. Did he say non-recurring expense? No, he did not mention any non-recurring expense. So take 10,400. I told you already, unsold stock, we have to take consignee expenses only when it is non-recurring expense. Did he mention non-recurring expenses? No. He said selling expense. Selling expense are what? Recurring expense. What is non-recurring expense? Expenses incurred till it reaches the godown of consignee. Any such expenditure incurred till it reaches the godown of the consignee, such expenses is called what? Non-recurring. In this problem, he did not mention, so don't take it. So 10,400 is what? Unsold stock. Now consignment stock reserve. Whenever there is unsold stock, you have to calculate what? Unsold stock reserve. For calculating unsold stock reserve,